Let's take a look at another example. So how long would you wait for these guys? So if I said, how do you spell the word through? Social? Do I need to memorize that? Or can I figure it out? And I can take that class that teaches me all about patterns of spelling and all that, right? But what was the other through?
Through the wall.
So is this an example of something I'm going to memorize? You've got to memorize how to spell through. I mean, the English language is crazy with spelling. We have to do a lot of memorizing those sight words in the English language. So do I wait on that? I might wait a little bit where the kid tries some stuff. But if he doesn't know how to spell through, he doesn't know how to spell through. And I can help him figure that out. How about if I were to ask you, what's the theme of the paragraph? We kind of already mentioned theme a little bit. Am I going to wait on that? Yeah, we're going to talk about it. We're going to construct. We're going to remember what theme is. We're going to pull back on other experiences. Remember when we talked about theme of that word? Remember you guys said it was, how does that relate to this particular word? What if I were to ask you for when Columbus found America? Somebody sing that rhyme for me right now. Louder.
Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492.
But why do we have a rhyme? Because it's social knowledge. That is something that, unless I tell you when Columbus came, can you figure that out? Now some of you are like, I can find that on Google. Finding on Google is retrieving from Google like you would retrieve from your rote memory. It's not the same thing as being able to sit and if I really think about things I know, I bet some kid who's never heard of Columbus could figure out when he found America. Okay, someone would have to tell you that example of social knowledge. Now if I ask a kid what makes America exceptional? Worth waiting on? Do I wait on that kind of thing? That's social, logical mathematical knowledge, not that social memorize-only stuff. All right, so what if I were to ask you, why is that happening in this experiment? Let's go a little science-y here. Why is that happening in this experiment? I need to wait on that, right? They should have that memorized.
Depends on the experiment.
Ooh, really? I don't know. Do we memorize the results of experiments? Why do we do them then? If we already know the result of the experiment because somebody told us, then why bother doing it? Unless we want to construct really what's going on with the phenomena. What is the science involved? What are the factors and the forces involved in this experiment? And I want to experience that. So a little bit of logical mathematical, I want to experience that experiment. If it's something I can memorize, then don't maybe experience it. Is the moon waxing or waning? Don't want to wait on that one? Why not wait on that? Do you know the definition of waxing? Do you know the definition of waning? And if you do, then you can answer your question. If you don't, sit there. How long are you going to sit there waiting? Figure that out.